जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विद श्रीराम पब्लिक स्कूल। टुडे वी विल सी द टॉपिक्स विच वी हैड ऑलरेडी स्टडीड। व्हाई? बिकॉज वी स्टार्टेड आवर क्लास विद द रिवीजन टेस्ट एंड इट वाज वेरी डिसअपॉइंटिंग टू सी दैट देयर वर वेरी सिली मिस्टेक्स इन द रिवीजन टेस्ट। टुडे वी विल सी ऑल द टॉपिक्स इन फ्यू मिनट्स एंड आई विल बी अटैचिंग अ PDF ऑफ नोट्स सो दैट यू माइट कंप्लीट योर नोट्स एंड यू माइट be having a record of what we have studied, and thereafter we'll be tomorrow next class onwards we'll be going towards the new topics. So without any delay, let's get started. Studied in English grammar, do you remember? Yes, we have studied sentence. So what was sentence? A group of words that make complete sense. Thereafter we have studied phrases, a group of words that does not make complete sense, but when it comes into a sentence, when we apply it into a sentence, it gives some sense. Thereafter we have seen clauses. In clauses we have seen that it has verb of its own, many a times it has subject of its own also, so it gives a complete meaning and it comes along with the sentence to complete its meaning, to give a complete meaning. Actually it adds on to the sentence. Thereafter we started with our parts of speech and we have seen not only today's modern grammar, in traditional grammar also there was a category of parts of speech. So lexical grammar, one word we have seen. Lexical means it stands for the words or vocabulary of a language. In lexical grammar there were many things like the parts of speech in the traditional world also. So history we have seen in Nirkuta of around 5th century. Today we are in 21st century. In 5th century around there was a grammarian known as Yaska, and he had classified the words into four category, that is noun, verb, prefix and particle it was. So we have seen all these things. Now things that you have to learn in this modern grammar is the types of 8 or 9 types of parts of speech. Now this 8 types of part of speech we will go one by one for today's class. The first one was noun. The noun you have studied since I think from first class onwards, but still I don't know why you people don't know about noun. The noun hai kya? It's actually the name of everything that exists around in this world. Along with it, what does noun do? सिस, क्योंकि नाम नाम है हर चीज़ का हमारे अराउंड, तो नाउन की जो कैटेगरी है और जो नाउन का काम है वो भी दोनों ही क्या है, नेमिंग है. तो नेमिंग, जैसे अलग अलग चीज़ों की नेमिंग होती है तो कैटेगरी भी नाउन का जो है वो ऐसे ही होता है. जब किसी ग्रुप को कॉमन नेम दिया जाता है तो वो कॉमन नाउन होता है. जब पूरे ग्रुप को ग्रुप की तरह रिप्रेजेंट किया जाता है तो वो कलेक्टिव नाउन होता है. उन्हीं ग्रुप में से जब एक पर्टिकुलर को उठाकर उसके बारे में बोला जाता है तो वो प्रॉपर नाउन होता है. वहीं अगर हम किसी फीलिंग, इमोशन की बात कर रहे हैं, जो चीज़ें टैंजिबल नहीं हैं, तो वो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन होता है, और जो चीज़ें हम टच कर सकते हैं वो कॉन्क्रीट नाउन होता है. सो दिस ऑल्सो नाउन हैज अ कैटेगरी ऑफ जेंडर्स, मैस्कुलिन जेंडर, फेमिनिन जेंडर, कॉमन जेंडर एंड न्यूटर जेंडर. ऑल्सो नाउन अगर नंबर में देखा जाए तो काउंटेबल नाउन, नॉन काउंटेबल नाउन भी एक कैटेगरी है. सो नाउन हैज़ मेनी थिंग्स टू स्टडी एंड दैट वी हैव सीन, बट स्टिल यू पीपल हैव डाउट, आई डोंट नो, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर रिवाइजिंग टुडे. नाउ प्रोनाउंस. Pronouns are substitute for nouns. See, every time we just can't go to the noun, and every time we can't say Ram is walking, Ram is going, or Ram is sleeping, Ram will eat, Ram. No, every time repeating the noun is like you are exaggerating it. You are creating atmosphere, just highlighting the name. So what do we use? We substitute the name with another word, and that another word would particularly be a pronoun. Now substitute a noun or pronoun again. When we substitute for proper noun, when we substitute for first person, third person, singular, plural, thus we give different categories of pronoun. Again we get, now personal pronoun is when it refers to person, demonstrative when it demonstrate, when it tells about some particular thing. So many types of pronouns also exist. Thereafter adjectives. Adjectives are modifiers. They add to the meaning, they modify. When we just say Ram is a boy, okay, he's a boy, okay, nothing happened. But when we modify it, when we add to it, Ram is a good boy, good is becomes the adjective. It describes Ram, it modifies, it gives more information about the noun. Next, verb. Of course, when there exists a noun or when there's a person, it will do something. The person will do something or thing. It will do something. So, things or persons, when doing something, the verbs which denote that action is known as verb. Now, again, since they are denoting action, there are different types of verbs also, transitive, intransitive. And there are verbs which help the main verb. Those are known as helping verbs. Thereafter, adverb. Now, someone is working. Okay, the person is working. But some people work efficiently in a better manner. Some just work and just finish it. So, the type of verb when described, it is described as adverbs in the category of adverbs. As the name itself indicates, add to the verb. When it describes the verb, add to the verb, adverb. So, it's add on to the verb. For example, I say he's walking or he's walking quickly. So, quickly describes the verb and thus it adds up to the verb and it's known as adverb. Next one. Preposition. As the name again itself indicates, see, English is all about if you know the meanings of the word. Position means jagah. So preposition means tells the place, the location of the phrase of the sentence or the subject or whatever it is. For example, the cat is sitting under the table. It's telling about the cat is sitting where? Under the table. So it's very clear, it's telling the position of the cat. So that's what preposition is. Now the thing what you have to see in preposition, with what you have to use which preposition. We all know under means below and below also means below. But what's the difference? So be attentive in the next class. Of course, we will see this only. Which preposition do we add up with what? So it's very important for your general life also, daily life also. You just have to say something to someone. So you must be knowing which preposition you need to use. So we'll be seeing that in the next class. See, I'm always reminding you people, grammar is not just about marks or subject. Grammar is about life. English you'll need everywhere. And if you need English, you'll need grammar. So don't skip the classes. Next. Conjunction. As itself, the word indicates, junction means joining and co means aapas mein. When aapas mein joining happens, that is known as conjunction. When we join two sentences, two phrases or two clauses by some words, those words are and, or, but, because, instead, whatever it is, unless, since, if. So when we join and those words which we use for joining is known as conjunction. Interjection. Inter means aapas mein. So the feelings that you express, interjection, the word itself means the expressive word. Interjection means expressive word. The word which expresses. So expressive words are out, wow, hey, help, oh, hi. Whatever the surprising words you are using. Okay. So this expresses the sudden emotion, sudden feeling. This is all about the parts of speech. Also, we have seen noun and pronoun in detail. So, verb also we have seen a bit, introduction we have seen and types we have seen. So, we will go thoroughly towards, now we will move forward with preposition. Thereafter, we will go to conjunctions. And thereafter, we will again come back to noun and common errors in noun. Thereafter, pronoun and common errors in pronoun. Thereafter, noun, pronoun and adjective together. Thereafter, verb and adverb together. And the common errors. Okay. So, be attentive for the classes. Don't miss the grammar classes. That it's very important. There's one more part of speech. Some people say it's a part of speech and some people do not include it in the section of parts of speech. This is article. Article is a very important component. Article is used before a noun. A is used when we denote one of something. And an is used before a vowel sound. That is, if there is a sound of A, E, I, O, U, we use an before it. And the is the definite article. When a definite person or thing we are talking about, we use the before it. The man. Whom you already know, you have to mention that man again. Then we use the man. See, see here in this sentence, in the example given, I need a dictionary. Already we have mentioned a dictionary. Now that we are again defining, then we use the dictionary needs to be in English. So it's a very easy. Three articles also, if you even keep it or include it under the section of parts of speech, it's not difficult to study it. Now, why is it important? Because see, thing is that there are many. Why do we need it? What? Why do we need the parts of speech? Where do we have to focus on? See, the same word can be used as different. Like increase here, the price is increased. Increase can be a verb. Increase can also be noun. There was increase in the price, or there was increase in the number of followers. So the problem comes where when we don't understand which part, which word is used as which part of speech in the sentence. Same word can be used differently. Please keep in mind that, and that is what we studied the common errors about. In common errors, we'll see that very easily you'll be able to rectify these things. Now let us see nouns. Noun in detail, we have already seen types of noun is very important. Common noun and proper noun. Common name given to some person, place or thing is the common noun. When a proper fixed name is given, it's proper noun. A proper noun, remember, always starts with the capital letter, and you people forget this many a times. Now how to spot a common noun and proper noun? When it's of course written in capital, that's very easy. But there are two questions which you can ask. When you ask the question, what is it? Kya hai wo cheez kya hai? It's a boy, he's a boy, it's a ball. When this question is asked and you get the answer of this question, it's the common noun. Whereas when you ask, what is its name? And the answer you get, that is the proper noun. Now next, abstract noun. Of course, the things that we cannot see or touch. For example, joy, happiness, determination. Where do we use it? Many creative writers use it in their writing. Concrete noun, that things you can see or touch. It's the opposite of abstract noun. It's also used by writers when they want to express the abstract noun. They use concrete noun as an INE. Collective noun, they are the words that we denote the groups. Herd of cattle, army of soldiers. Collective noun is singular or plural, depends. As I already told you, when it gives a unified sense, single sense, it is singular. When the sense is different or the opinion is divided, it is plural. Compound noun, when there are two nouns in one. For example, pickpocket, when it's made up of more than one word. Water bottle. Gender specific noun, there are four, as we have seen just now. I told you masculine, feminine, common, neuter. Countable, uncountable, which we can count is countable, uncountable that we cannot count. Of course, it's very easy. Still, I don't know why you people do commit mistakes. I don't know. Gerunds are also noun, ing form of the verb when they are used as subject. Gerunds we all should be knowing, because to reduce the number of words, we can easily use a gerund in the starting of a sentence and we can reduce our number of words. Now verbal noun, they are also derived from verbs, but they are not actually verbs, they are actually nouns. ing form, it is also ing forms. Now why, when we see verbal nouns are usually preceded by a, an, or the, and followed by a preposition. So we can see that and we can identify it easily. Now issue one was that you have to use a capital letter before a proper noun only, and for proper noun very strictly you have to use. Treat collective noun as singular and go plural if the context is different. If it dictates or if it goes away, you have to treat it as plural. For example, when we say the opinion of the members of the committee was different, the opinions were different, then it is plural. Where will be correct? Now issue 3 is noun phrase. You have to see subject verb agreement is a very important thing. If the subject is singular, the verb should be singular. So we'll also see a video on subject verb agreement. If still you want to know anything else in noun, or if you want to study if there's any problem, you can just tell. I'll make a proper explanation of it and present it to you. That's all for this video. Thank you so much. Have a good day.